listen hard. Hear it. Seen and heard.
This band formed out of the Descendants, which were formed in 78. Stefan and I hooked up in 86. We've been going ever since. We've had numerous singer changes, I guess. So it's a long history we're sort of upholding here. It's kind of funny. We just find success on a creative level if we're happy with our songs, blah, blah, blah. And the commercial success thing is something that we have to look at like this. Well, we weren't popular people in high school either, so. Does not surprise us that we're not popular now. That stuff that drives you crazy and the stuff that breaks bands up is when you start worrying too much about the money side of it, the business side of it, the popularity side of it, and on the other extreme of that, just the wretched living conditions sometimes you live under, and you know, in the face of absolute ignorance and apathy trying to do your art or whatever. You can drive yourself crazy with those. So you basically try to concentrate on the music itself and what you're trying to say with the music itself and the playing of it. And that's the only stuff that'll help you save what little sanity you may possess. We get a lot of letters from kids that say our songs really affected them fairly deeply and personally, and people write saying, you know, I can't believe you wrote song whatever because I just went through that with my life, you know. And it's kind of nice. So there's a universality to the stuff we sing about. It's very day-to-day life, and I think it's a lot easier to identify with than a lot of the current crop of bands that have very abstract lyrics. Because the abstract lyric, you can read anything into it. We're very realist. We're almost like country music lyrics, kinda. It's a lot of hurt and love songs, you know. We don't have too many songs about you know, our dog dying yet. But yeah, it's like country music. It's real personal statements and stuff. We have four songwriters. And that's more than most bands ever have, and it makes our records, if in a positive light, it makes each one of them very different. In a negative light, it makes them very inconsistent and not as much of a good pop commodity, I suppose. But we don't care about it, so. It'd be very dull to go out and make a record, the same record again and again, and I know quite a few bands that do that, and they're usually quite commercially successful. So are we stupid because we know this stuff and we're not getting on the gravy train? You know, is there some kind of weird nobility to what we're doing? I don't know. We're all nerds, kind of. We read too much and party too little, I think, to be a cohesive rock band in a way. I mean, Chad, he's young and fresh. He parties a little more strenuously than the rest of us. He's not quite as nerdy. I don't know. It's like we were the people that you made fun of in high school. And if you've ever wondered why we're yelling so damn loud or playing so damn fast, a lot of it's just that frustration. It's still coming out. I mean, when you're made an outcast socially, it forces you to revel in your antisocial thing. You know, it's like, what makes me uncool? Well, punk rock was one way for us to turn it inside out and point, you know, oh, you don't think we're cool? Okay, we'll see how not cool we can make ourselves for you. Let's do something. This is something for us. This is our statement of where we are. And it's not cool to you? Sorry.
I mean, an off-fan is a weird breed of person. First of all, like, to be an off-fan, you have to have 15 or 16 CDs, because that's how many we have. And you have to have, like, every T-shirt, and you have to have a tattoo on your arm. And it's just, it's like joining the army, kind of, or something. No, I mean, figuratively speaking, it's like joining the army, almost, in these people.
Like the KISS army?
Well, no, they make it up themselves, though, the people, like, we have nothing to do with it. They go beyond diehard. They know every word, every song and stuff. It's so I'm so flattered or moved by it, I wouldn't even be able to explain it to you. You'd have to see it. I don't know how this city here is for that, because we haven't been here in a while, but It's really interesting to just be these, because they're nerds. They're like, they're the future computer programmers of America. Like, they have no friends. They're never going to get laid. All they have is like their all show or something. You know, maybe they go see some other band. It's like they're not, they're ugly and stuff. And they're me. They're me when I was in high school.
To Psychometry Today with your resident host and psychometrist, Dave Spivey.
Thank you, one and all.
I'm getting some, could you stand up here? I'm getting some very powerful psychic. Your aura is on fire. Have you recently met someone?
Yeah.
Really? Was that? All right, my psychic guide, very strong. You're going to die.
Everybody says they want $1 million bucks, but I'd rather have $1 million days with you. My account doesn't go that high. It doesn't mean you have to say goodbye to me. I can't promise you $1 million bucks, but I can promise that I'll be good to you. Everybody wants $1 million bucks, but I'd rather have $1 million days with you. Day one, we go fishing. Dollar movies on day two. Day three and four, we spend in bed. The side we used to do. 1 million days with you would go by much too fast. I've got 1 million ways to make our friendship last. I've got 1 million ways. Everybody says they want $1 million bucks, but I'd rather have 1 million days with you. My account doesn't go that high. It doesn't mean you have to say goodbye to me. Day five, we would ride our bikes, camping on day six. Day seven and eight, I'd show you how much I love you. 1 million days with you would go by much too fast. I've got 1 million ways to make our friendship last. I've got 1 million ways. Everybody says they want $1 million bucks, but I'd rather have 1 million days with you. My account doesn't go that high. It doesn't mean you have to say goodbye to me. I can't promise you $1 million bucks, but I can promise that I'll be good to you. Everybody wants $1 million bucks, but I'd rather have 1 million days with you. 1 million days with you. 1 million days with you.
Please call my psychic companions. This powerful network of psychics has enough energy to light the city of Las Vegas for a weekend.
If there's someone talking to you from a stage and trying to convince you of a political or philosophical notion, take who they are with a grain of salt. It's like, let's see, do I really think this guy's opinion matters in my perspective? Let's see, he's a punker, he never went to college, or he did go to college. Well, you can just take it whichever way, but you got to qualify it a little.
I've never looked at it as like a serious career because it is, after all, just punk rock.
Hey, my name is Mr. Poopyhead from Furnaceface. Don't forget to watch Seen and Heard on Victoria's Shaw Cable 11.